Hi, I'm Ryland Hunter.
And I'm Bryce Lebeau.
And you are checking out the world premiere of Huskie Central. So Bryce, man, beyond all reason, they gave us a web show. I don't even know what we're supposed to talk about.
Well, I think it's about Huskie athletes and all the great Huskie athletes we have here.
So what you're telling me is every week on Thursday, we're going to be able to hook up everybody with everything they need to know about Huskie athletics.
Everything from top scorers to top tens.
Absolutely. This sounds like it's going to be a lot of fun.
So Ryland, tell us, who's your favorite Huskie of all time?
Well, Bryce, I'm glad you asked. My favorite Huskie is most definitely Big Brent Dancy. Played D-line on the Huskie football team for about 5 years. I always went to the Huskie football camp in the summer being a Saskatoon kid, and he was always my coach. And he was the one guy who understood that, you know what, when a man watches The Lion King, he's bound to cry.
That's very true.
Absolutely. All right, Bryce, I got to have a bit of real talk with you now, though. I mean, I'm a Saskatoon boy, born and raised. Makes sense why I'm here, man. I love this school, always did, right? But you're a bit of an outsider, you know what I'm talking about. You're from Regina, man. What's the deal?
I am, actually. I didn't really know I was going to go into school after high school, and in my grade 12 year, I was watching the 06 Mitchell Bowl. The football team was playing Laval, and I watched Jordy Burroughs knock a pass down on the last play of the game, and at that point, I think it was just love at first sight, you know, kind of like The Lion King.
Absolutely, man. When something touches your heart, you can't say no. Who are you to argue?
Isn't that the truth? So maybe just a little get to know us here. I'm number 27. I play DB on the football team. I'm in commerce. This is my second year. Maybe just tell them a little bit about yourself, Ryland.
Yeah, same sort of situation. I came in 2 years ago, too. I'm number 39. I play linebacker, and I'm studying nutrition here at school.
Is it nutrition?
Well, it's nutrition.
It doesn't really show, though, man.
I'm working hard, man. You know what? I'm just doing the best I can with what God gave me.
Well, I guess let's just roll the clips. Hey, Ryland, it might be a little early to bring out the brooms, but the Huskie women's basketball team swept on the holiday break, and they cleaned up in their tournament.
No way.
3-0, yeah, absolutely.
Did you hear about the guys' volleyball team?
Doing well again, obviously.
They were doing pretty well, and then they ran into a few old school studs from the Huskie alumni team that stopped them short in the final.
And here are your scores from last weekend. Now check out your Huskie Athlete of the Week and your Canwest Athlete of the Week.
Danny Stone from the women's hockey team was named the Canada West Athlete of the Week. The second year forward out of Prince Albert scored a hat trick and had two helpers as the women's hockey team defeated Lethbridge in both of their games. Her teammate Brianne George, third year forward, also will be named a Huskie Athlete of the Week, as she had three goals and two helpers all in the power play as they swept the Pronghorns.
Get your drink.
Get your seat.
Make some noise.
The basketball teams are at home this weekend, Friday against Trinity Western University and Saturday against Simon Fraser University. The women will be at 6 and the men will be at 8. On the track and field, there will be a prairie duel at the Saskatoon Fieldhouse on Saturday. In women's and men's volleyball, they play both Friday and Saturday night at the University of Calgary. And in wrestling, there will be a Golden Bear Invitational Tournament on Saturday and Sunday in Edmonton.
Looking at the women's basketball standings, they're two games back of Regina right now, sitting in second place at 5-3. Over on the men's side, they're sitting at an even 500 with 4 wins and 4 losses, 3 games back of first place Calgary Dinos.
In hockey, the women are just in third place, 1 point out of second, just behind Manitoba. In men's hockey, they're in third place, 1 point behind second place Calgary and Manitoba.
In the volleyball standings, we got your women sitting 1-9 right now, just starting to pick up a little momentum, getting ready for that strong second half. On the men's side, big Matt Bussey has led Saskatchewan to sit just one game back in first place as they're ready to make a move as well. The Huskies are going Hollywood. If you can't make it to the pack to check it out live, you check out the webcast online where both the men's and the women's basketball teams will be showed in their entirety from this weekend.
This is Bryson Ryland with an interview with women's basketball coach LT. She's obviously right now the rose between the thorns, so we'll start off maybe. How was your break?
It was great, thanks. How was yours?
It was wonderful, thank you. I understood that you guys had multiple games.
We did. We played 3 games just after Christmas. Played 2 against Laurentian and 1 against Alberta, and they went fairly well, so we're looking forward to starting the
game. Yeah, we understand that you guys went 3-0, and what were the keys maybe to those games?
I think our team defense has improved and our rebounding and quite frankly, I guess our transition offense is coming along, so we're hoping to take that, like I said, into conference play coming this weekend.
Awesome.
You're looking at a couple, one we'll call serious fans, certainly not casual. What can we expect from the style of play and sort of from you guys in the second half? You're sitting in second place right now.
Yeah.
What's your prediction sort of going forward?
Well, we need to make some headway here. We need to pull out some wins. We need some help from some other teams. But I think our matchups are pretty good coming up here. We've got some tough games with Simon Fraser coming up and Trinity Western. And, you know, heading into the end of January, we have really, we have to play some great team defense and to continue to work on our team and sort of transition offense. It's a nice one of theirs.
All right, and talking about SFU Clan, as some people may not know, they are the reigning champions. Maybe just tell us a little bit about what's going to take to beat them, and maybe some things that you guys are going to work on.
I think they're on a 46-game winning streak that dates back to last year, so we would love more than anything else to break their streak. For them, I mean, they're a powerful team. They're huge. They can really shoot the three. They get the ball inside well. So for us, we're going to play great team defense. And offensively, if anything, I think they probably don't guard the ball as well as some other teams. So we're going to have to be very aggressive offensively.
Okay, awesome.
Coach, from what I understand from talking to a few of your players, I hear that you're maybe one of the biggest pranksters that the University of Saskatchewan has in the world. Counter to that, though, I've heard you can go quite dictatorship to prankster at the drop of a hat. If you had maybe one of those pranks you just relive for us, the viewers would love to hear about it.
I don't know if I'm a great prankster. Apparently I make fun of my players quite often.
There's a lot to make fun of.
There is a lot to make fun of.
Do you have any nicknames maybe per se that you want to toss out on air for maybe your players?
Other than calling them by their last name, Kimbo.
I heard that's because she reminds everybody of an angry MMA fighter.
I think so, yeah. Yeah, she can break it out, that's for sure. But you don't want to get her when she wakes up on the wrong side of the bed. She can be pretty angry and pretty grumpy. But yeah, beyond that, I'm sorry I can't share too much.
Yes, what happens on the road, Steve.
Hey, we're here with Jill Humbert, love my life. I just told you that now, so it's a little awkward. But we're gonna talk basketball, we're gonna forget what I just said. You guys got a huge matchup coming up this weekend. SFU, was it 46 games in a row? Somebody's gotta stop that. What are you guys thinking?
Yeah, they've been number one for the past couple years, but we're feeling like this might be our year to take them down.
Absolutely. What types of things do you guys think you need to do to be able to compete with them at their level?
Well, they always play good and they always execute their game plan. They're very, very disciplined, so we need to play our best game to beat them for sure. We gotta definitely limit our turnovers and rebounds because they're big.
Alright, your coach had said a little bit, Lisa said that you guys need to play great defense. Where does that come in this all?
Yeah, definitely. We're playing our best and we get stops on defense. We push the ball and run transition, so getting stops is definitely key for us.
We were just talking, you guys had a bit of a tune-up tournament over the break. I know we got a couple of games. And from what I understand, you took home a big trophy. Tell us about the tournament.
Yeah, we had Laurentian come up from the East. We played them twice, had some good games against them. And then U of A came down, and they're always a rival of ours, so it's good that we beat them in the final.
Was the rumor that you guys brought out the brooms for that tournament? Or how did
we swept the floor.